Hello and welcome to part one of my documentary. So, I'm very glad that you could come and listen to my documentary. So basically, in this documentary, I'm going to do it in multiple parts and then put them all together to make a full, as long as I possibly can, documentary. Okay, so what this documentary is about is why you should not put a penny in your eye and blind yourself. Okay, so. Let's start off with something simple. What is the penny? So, the penny is a form of currency used in both America, England, and probably some other place. Okay, so the penny is probably the most useless piece of money thing ever invented, because the penny is worth one penny, and that's the smallest currency possibly can go these days. Especially in England. The thing is, the penny can be used for many things, such as buying a single gummy bear from a sweet shop, or putting it in your eyes. So let's go through buying a single gummy bear from the sweet shop first. So, buying a single gummy bear from the sweet shop is completely ridiculous. Why would you go to a sweet shop to buy one gummy bear? But if you have 100 pennies with you at the sweet shop, you can buy 100 gummy bears. Now, you could probably get away with getting 110 gummy bears by just saying that you counted them wrong, or not even saying anything about your counting. Just say there is 100 gummy bears in this bag, because they won't want to count. Hand them the 100 pennies, or even maybe 90, and if they don't count, then you'll get away with 90 pennies, 110 gummy bears. That's 20 more gummy bears than what you actually paid for. So the penny is great for that kind of stuff. Or you could go to the Gucci store and spend, like, I don't know, 10 million pennies on some new Gucci flip-flops or a new Gucci belt, because, you know, that's the most valuable item of clothing, the Gucci belt. But anyway, so you see, the penny is small, but not as small as the 5 pence coin. 5 pence coin is smaller than the penny, but it's worth more for some reason. 5 pence coin is worth 5 pennies. To be honest, the biggest coin is either the 2 pound coin or the 50 pence coin. But you see, in other countries, they may have bigger coins. Now, you see, the problem with pennies is that there's practically only two things you can do with them: buy one single gummy bear with your single penny. Or you could, you know, put it in your eyes. Or maybe make a stack. That's the third thing. That's the third and final thing. There's three things you can use a penny for. Now, the thing is, though, to make a stack of pennies, you need multiple pennies, and that can cost a lot of pennies. So you don't want to do that. I'm going to save you pennies to put in your eyes. So, now, putting your pennies in your eyes. The thing is, with putting pennies in your eyes, there is a risk of blinding yourself. Now, you don't want to blind yourself when you're putting pennies in your eyes. So, I'll walk you through the steps of what this is. But before we do that, let's just quite take a quicker 5 second break. Just listen to silence. Now, another 5 second break. You see, that was 10 seconds, but are you complaining? No. But anyway, let's get back onto the documentary, shall we? Okay, so a penny. People, especially young children, will see the penny and think, "Wow, that's about the same size and shape of my eye." So they're like, "I'm gonna put this penny in my eye. I'm gonna have it in my eyelid, so it looks like the penny is my eye." Now, you see, when people do this, they don't understand the risk of blinding yourself with that penny. So that penny has to be taken care of. So you see, when you put in a penny in your eye, make sure that you're very, very careful. You don't want the penny to go into your eye. So make sure that you only put it in your eyelid with your eye closed. So I recommend closing your eyelids and then opening up your, well, lifting up your brow so you can put the penny in and then tighten your eyelids so that it holds the penny in place. Now, if you're doing it with two pennies, you can't see what you're doing and you can't use a mirror. So, you'd have to put them both in at the same time and make sure you do exactly the same thing with both eyes and both pennies. Now, also, make sure that your fingers don't go into your eye because that could kill you. As you know, bleeding out through your eyes is not pleasant. Unless you didn't know, bleeding out through your eyes is when blood comes out of your eyes. I'm not sure how blood doesn't already come out of your eyes because your pupil is just a large hole. But anyway, okay, so. The thing is with putting pennies in your eyes, if you bleed on the pennies and the blood goes all crusty and gets stuck to the penny, then there's nothing you can do with that penny. Unless you find a way to clean it, maybe in a car wash. You can't use that penny again because nobody wants to touch your crusty blood that came out of your eyes while you're trying to put the penny in your eyes. So, what you need to do is take caution when putting pennies in your eyes and don't blind yourself. Okay, so, when you're putting a penny in your eyes, you don't want to blind yourself like this person did. So somebody going by the name of I can't remember again, but yeah, they put a penny in their eye and blinded themselves. Well, that's what they said. I'm not sure if they actually did, but you see, when you're putting the penny in your eye, you don't want to blind yourself like that person who I can't remember the name of did. Okay, so yeah, let's take a quick 10-second break and I'll be back. So then, putting pennies in your eyes can be a controversial topic because people view currency in a different way. Like in a country like, let's say, Vietnam, I'm pretty sure their currency is not worth as much as the British currency. So they would see the penny as more valuable than us and they would not want to put it in their eyes. I'm not sure what the equivalent of one penny is in Vietnamese dong, but I assure you it is more than we would take it as. So, to them, one penny for them, whatever their currency is more than what a penny is to us, as what we view it as. We view the penny as practically worthless, and we often discard this currency because it is practically useless. Like, when you commonly get these pennies, mostly, when you go to the store, or you're shopping online, or you're buying something, and you spend your money, and the price of that item ends in 99. Now this is a trap, and don't fall for it. Don't ask for the change. Say keep the change, because you don't want that penny. That penny is probably the worst thing you'll ever receive in your life. It's a piece of metal that's somehow a lot less valuable than a slip of paper. Now, if your change is a slip of paper with a number on it, then that is exactly what you need. That's the only change you require. Unless it's in coins that contain over 5 pence. 5 pence is okay to get. And, you know, it's actually worth something. You can get 5 whole gummy bears from the sweet shop with that money. But you see, with one penny, there's not much you can do about that. So, be careful when you're shopping, because you might end up getting yourself a penny. And I don't think anyone actually wants a penny, because the penny is just stupid. Excuse my language there, I said the S word then. But the penny really is just stupid. You can't do many things with it. There's 3 things that we have covered that you can do with it. So now I've covered the first 2 things you can do with it. What about the third thing, making a stack of pennies? Now, making a stack of pennies is a good way to organize your currency and count them. I suggest making a stack of 10 pennies each time. 10 stacks of 10 pennies would be £1. You can actually get stuff with that, like 100 single gummy bears. So, you might have to purchase each one of these separately, which would be 100 trips to the counter and back. Or you could and just put them all in a bag and buy them all at once. So this is the 10-minute mark of this documentary, and I'm thinking that so far we have covered plenty. And I'm thinking that this documentary should be seen in schools about next year, because maybe by the end of this year, I'm hoping, because I think it's a very, very, you know, required subject that I don't think any schools have ever talked about, ever, in the history of history. So now, you see, the history of the penny has been covered here. It's useful for three things, and the third we haven't quite covered yet. And, you know, this whole penny thing, you know, people would overlook it. They'd think, I don't need to know about pennies, it's just a penny. But you really do need to know about pennies. It's important for you. It's important for your health, it's important for your life, it's important that you know how to manage your money with pennies. And also that you don't put them in your eyes and blind yourself. So, basically, anyway, back to making a stack of pennies. A stack of pennies is a good way to count how much pennies you have. Because if you have them in stacks of 10, you don't have to count each individual penny, you just have to count up to 10, and once you've done all that, you can just go in the 10 times table and count how many stacks you have. If you have a stack that doesn't have 10 pennies, then you make sure that you count each one of those to make sure you have the exact amount of pennies, and you know how many you have. And then those pennies can be converted at the bank into some useful form of currency, like a pound. Now you see, a pound is a bit bigger than a penny, but the pound can also be put in your eyes. But that means that something that you can put in your eyes comes with the risk of you being able to blind yourself. Now look, you don't want to blind yourself with a pound, because a pound is heavier than a penny. And it will sink inside of your eyes, and you'll never be able to see again. You'll be completely blind. So, you see, you don't want to mess around with your currency, because you could put it in your eyes as a joke to be funny, and look like you have coins as eyes. You may want to look rich, so you put pennies in your eyes, and you wear them like that. You may cut holes in them so you can see through them and have penny glasses. Maybe with a thin wire to hold them onto your face. But, you know, the important thing is, you don't want to, you know, get your pennies out and then be in front of your friends, put the pennies in your eyes as a joke, you know, to make them all laugh, to have a good time. And then you blind yourself, because they'll end up laughing at you and you'll get bullied for it for the rest of your life. Because that's how friends work. Now you see, people who think that the penny has no uses whatsoever, throw it in the bin, are completely wrong. They should save up their pennies, and then they are able to, you know, spend it on things once they save up enough. And I think that pennies are probably the best thing that's ever happened to this world, because pennies can be used for so many other things. If you have enough pennies, you can save up to buy, I don't know, something like a furnace. Or maybe something that you can melt your pennies in. And then you can get the copper from the pennies, its purest form. And make anything you want out of that copper. You could make a large penny out of copper. And I'd say that's pretty cool. So, you know, make sure you keep your pennies. Save them up to buy a furnace, make a large penny that would be worth as many pennies as you put in there, and then you don't have to carry millions of pennies around. You can just melt that penny again, get something like a cookie cutter in the shape of a penny, cut them all out back into pennies, hand them out, and you can buy stuff in the most efficient way possible. Melt them all down so they are still solid, slightly liquefied, so they're kind of squidgy metal, like molten almost. And then you can use a hydraulic press to compress it in every single direction you possibly can to make the most compact penny you can, and that would be pretty amazing. You know, I think that'd be pretty cool. So a lot of people don't like the penny. We've now covered that. We've covered the three uses of a penny, the three only uses of a penny discovered so far. And those are they are you know, can't remember what they are. Oh yes. The making a stack with a penny, making a stack with a multiple penny, with one penny, making a stack of pennies would be the most useless thing ever. More on that after we've covered the list. So we have why pennies are useless, why pennies are useful. We have the disadvantages and advantages of pennies coming up soon. I hope you enjoy that bit. That'll take about 5 more minutes, or maybe 4.5, or maybe 4:20. But anyway, we've covered making a stack with a penny, putting pennies in your eyes and not blinding yourself, putting pennies in your eyes and blinding yourself. Two possible outcomes of putting pennies in your eyes. And there's also buying a single gummy bear. Now, advantages and disadvantages of a penny. Now, pennies are quite interesting with their advantages and disadvantages. Their advantages, they're small. And they are also copper. Copper is cool because it's copper. Now, copper is metal, and metal should be worth more than paper. But apparently paper is more, like, worth more and more valuable than a metal coin. So we use paper notes, like £50 notes, there's $100 notes. And people think that that is better than a coin, a piece of metal dug from underground that takes effort to get. It's harder to find, or harder to find than paper, that is, because paper grows on trees. Paper is trees. Trees are paper. Trees are everywhere. We can make as many trees as we want. We have an infinite source of trees. But you see, people think, hey, there's people dying in mines to find this metal that we can use as currency to make coins. Valuable items that we can spend on things to make them worth something. A way that we control our society so people can get things done. But what if money is a scam? Because money is made of non-valuable items, such as copper. Silver is valuable, but it's not used to make coins. That's just the colour of them. It's probably just some silly metal used like plastic. It's not even metal, it's just coloured in with metallic Sharpie so we believe it's metal. Strong plastic is like metal. People have said that, you know, like, they think that plastic toys painted metallically are metal. So, they're like, huh, well this is interesting, because it looks like a metal, but it's not. It's made to make you think that it's a valuable item, more valuable than plastic. Plastic is probably the most invaluable substance on Earth because of its pollutory values, if that's even a word. But it is now. I'm going to add that to the Oxford Dictionary, only the Oxford Dictionary. No other dictionary will have it, so make sure you buy that. Not sponsored. But I'm thinking that we should start making coins more valuable again. A £100 coin to make metal more valuable. We could literally make it out of plastic, but write £100 on the front, and like the government just needs to say, this is a £100 coin, it's worth £100. And then people would believe that it's worth that much, but it's just a piece of plastic. So you see, I think that pennies are the source of the Illuminati, you see? All of this stuff that's happening, all because of money. Crime only happens because people want money. So you see, if pennies didn't exist, the world wouldn't exist the same way that it does. There'd be no government, nobody would be in power, anything could happen. Nobody would go to work because there's no point, because without money, without pennies, there would be no way to make work worth it. People would have to work, but they wouldn't want to. The thing that motivates them to work is pennies, or money in general. So you see, pennies are actually not as useless as you think. But that's just the advantages. There's also disadvantages to pennies. Like, you need to carry a lot of them to have enough for anything. Now, if you don't carry at least 100 pennies with you, you're not going to be able to buy many things other than a few single gummy bears from the sweet shop. You'll practically only be allowed to go to the sweet shop and buy anything with pennies, because they won't accept them anywhere else. Like, once I went to the sweet shop called Meg's, and I bought 100 gummy bears for 100 pennies. I didn't have it in pennies, but I had it in a pound coin. 1 pound coin is made at 100 pennies. So without pennies, 1 pound would not be worth anything. You can't have a 50 pence, a 2 pence, a 5 pence, 20 pence, a 1 pound, 2 pound, or 20 pound, 10 pound, 5 pound, any amount of money without pennies. Because if there was a 2 pence, there's no 1 pence, there's less variations of currency. You can't have as much variation as there is, like having things that cost 99p to get you that extra penny. Now, you see, when you have your stack of pennies, maybe 100 pennies, 100 stacks of 10 pennies, that's £10, you can start to buy things. You can go to the bank, convert them all into some useful form of currency, which we've covered is the penny. So I encourage you all to take all of your money that you own and have ever seen in your life. Take it all to the bank, get it converted into pennies, then take those pennies and buy stuff. Because then we can make the penny worth more than anything. But the less we use the penny, the more valuable it gets, because the rarer it becomes. So you see, using pennies less often makes them become less demanded. There's less need for them. You don't need to create them as urgently as, let's say, pound coins, because people use them a lot, especially younger people who need to buy food. They'd go to the shop with a few pound coins, buy yourself a sandwich, a drink, maybe some crisps, and then they would give the shopkeeper their pound coins in return for their items that they have decided to bring and buy, or whatever. But you see, if people use the penny less, the penny becomes worth more than a penny. If there's a shortage of pennies, people can sell pennies for valuable money to collectors. Like, you can sell a penny in 2 million years' time, if humans are even alive then, for like £2 billion, because it's been discontinued for a million years. So you see, it'd become extremely rare, because of people just throwing them away and not needing them, that they would become so valuable that the penny is the supreme currency. Owning one penny would make you the richest person on the planet. The more pennies you have, the richer you are. So don't forget, like Tesco says, every little helps. So now, to continue my documentary to 30 minutes or more, I'm going to continue by reading the Wikipedia article of pennies. So pennies, quite interesting, and they're so interesting that whoever the hell makes Wikipedia decided to make an entire article that is extremely long about pennies. So I'm going to continue to read this. This article is about the coin. For other uses of penny or pennies, see penny. Pence redirects here for the 48th Vice President of the United States, see Mike Pence. For other uses, see pence. Okay, I have no clue what any of that means, but luckily it has links to tell me. But this title relates to more than one page. Okay. A penny is a coin, pennies, or a unit of currency, pence, in various countries, borrowed from the Carolingian denarius, whence is its former abbreviation D. It is used usually the smallest denomination within a currency system. Presently, this is the formal name of the British penny, P, and the informal name of 1 American cent, as well as the informal Irish designation of 1 cent euro coin, C. It It is the informal name of the cent unit of account in Canada, although 1 cent coins are no longer minted there. The name is also used in reference to various historical currencies, also derived from the Carolingian system, such as the French denier and the German Pfennig. It may also be informally used to refer to any similar smallest denomination coin, such as the Euro cent or Chinese fen. I'm assuming that that also means that it's probably used in context with the smallest amount that you can possibly get with Vietnamese dong, or whatever it's called. Vietnamese small dong. There's a penny. Anyway, let's continue. The Carolingian penny was originally a 9.940 fine silver coin weighing 1 over 240 pound. It was adopted by Offa of Mercia and the other English kings, and remained the principal currency in Europe over the next few centuries until repeated debasements necessitated the development of more valuable coins. The British penny remained a silver coin until the expense of Napoleonic Wars prompted the use of the base metals in 1797, despite the declination of currencies in the United States and later throughout the British Commonwealth, the name remains in formal use. Right then. No parent penny is currently formally subdivided, although farthings, 1/4d, half pennies, and half cents have previously been minted at the mill, and the mill, 1 out of 10 cents, remains in use as a unit of account in some contexts. Okay, so that is the introduction to what a penny is and its origins. So we will now continue to the name of the penny, the history of the name of the penny, and further continue to the history of the penny used in different countries. Okay, so the name. Penny is first attested in a 1394 Scots text, which is Scottish for stupid people out there. A variant of Old English, penny, a development of numerous variations, including penning, and pending. The etymology of the term penny is uncertain, although cognates are common across almost all German languages and suggest a base pan, or pand, with the individualizing suffix ing. Common suggestions include that it was originally panding as a low Franconian or Fransonian form of Old High German Pfand Porn, in the sense of a pledge or debt, as in a pawnbroker putting up collateral as a pledge for repayment of loans. Panning is a form of the West Germanic word for frying pan, presumably owing to its shape, and ponding is a very early borrowing of Latin pondus or pound. Recently, it has been proposed that it may represent an early borrowing of Punic pane or penne, face, as the face of Carthaginian goddess Tanit was represented on nearly all Carthaginian currency. Following declamization, the British and Irish coins were marked new penny until 1982 and 1985, respectively. Okay, that is the start of the penny, the first start of the penny. Now we're going to go to the next part of the pennies. And this will hopefully be the most interesting thing you've ever learned in your life. The regular plural pennies fell out of use in England from the 16th century, except in reference to coins considered individually. It remains common in Scottish English and is standard for all senses in American English, where, however, the informal penny is typically only used of the coins in any case, values being expressed in cents. The informal name of the American cent seems to have spread from New York State. In British English, prior to declamation, values from 2 to 11 pence and of 20 pence are often written and spoken as a single word, 2 pence or tuppence, 3 pence or threepence. Other values were usually expressed in terms of shillings and pence, written as two words, which may or may not have been hyphenated. Where a single coin represented a number of pence, it was treated as a single noun, 6 pence or 2 8-pences. Thus, 3 pence would be a single coin of that value, whereas 3 pence would be its value, and 3 pennies would be three penny coins. In British English, divisions of a penny were added to such combination without a conjunction as 6 pence farthing, and such constructions were also treated as single nouns. Adjectival use of such coins used the ending penny as sixpenny. The British abbreviation D derived from the Latin denarius. It followed the amount after a space. It had been replaced since declamation by using P, usually written without a space or a period, from this abbreviation. It is common to speak of pennies and values in pence as P in North America. It is also common to abbreviate cents with the currency symbol C, which is a C with a little line going through it diagonally. It's like a C and a forward slash. Elsewhere, it is usually written with a simple C. So that's where the name of the penny came from, and what it actually is. That was pretty interesting. I've never known more about pennies in my life. I mean, I only knew like 4 uses of them, but there's a lot more about them, which I'll cover later. The medieval silver penny was modelled on similar coins in antiquity, such as the Greek drachma, the Carthaginian shekel, the Roman denarius. Forms of these have seemed to have reached as far as Norway and Sweden. The use of Roman currency in Britain seems to have fallen off the Roman withdrawal and subsequent Saxon invasions. Frankish Empire. Charlemagne's father, Pepin the Short, instituted a major currency reform around AD 755, aiming to reorganize France's previous silver standard with a standardized 0.940 fine denier, Latin for denarius, weighing 1 over 240 pounds, as the Carolingian pound seems to have been about 489.5 grams. Each penny weighed about 2 grams, and around 790, Charlemagne introduced a new 0.950 or 0.960 fine penny with a smaller diameter. Surviving specimens have an average weight of about 1.7 grams, although some estimate the original ideal mass at 1.76 grams. Despite the purity and quality of these pennies, however, they were repeatedly rejected by traders throughout the Carolingian period in favour of the gold coins used elsewhere, in a situation that led to repeated legislation against such refusal to accept the king's currency. England. Some of the Anglo-Saxon kingdoms initially copied the solidus, the late Roman gold coin. At the time, however, gold was so rare and valuable that even the smallest coin had such great value that they could only be used in very large transactions and was sometimes not available at all. Around AD 641 to 670, there seems to have been a movement to use coins with a lower gold content. This decreased their value and may have increased the number that could be minted, but these paler coins did not seem to have solved the problem of value and scarcity of the currency. The miscellaneous silver skaters minted in Frisia and Anglo-Saxon England after around 680 were probably known as pennies at the time. The misnomer is based on a probable misreading of the Anglo-Saxon legal codes. Their purity varied, and the weight fluctuated from about 0.8 to about 1.3 grams. They continued to be minted in East Anglia under Beona and in Northumbria as late as the mid-9th century. The Carolingian-style pennies were introduced by King Offa of Mercia, 757 to 796, modelled on Pepin's system. His first series was 1 over 240 of the Saxon pound of 5,400 grains, 350 grams, giving a penny weight of about 1.46 grams. His queen, whatever that says, also minted these coins under her own name. Near the end of his reign, Offa minted his own coins in imitation of Charlemagne's reformed pennies. Offa's coins were limited by East Anglia, Kent, Wessex, and Northumbria, as well as by two archbishops of Canterbury, as in Frankish Empire. As in the Frankish Empire, all of these pennies notionally composed shillings and pounds, but during this period neither large unit was minted. Instead, they functioned as only notional units of account. For instance, a shilling or solidus of grain was a measure equivalent to the amount of grain that 12 pennies could purchase. English currency was not notionally 0.925 fine sterling silver at the time of Henry II, but the weight of value of the silver penny steadily declined from 1300 onwards. In 1257, In 1257, Henry III minted a gold penny which had the nominal value of 1 shilling 8 pence. At first, the coin proved unpopular because it was overvalued for its weight. By 1265, it was so undervalued, the bullion value of its gold being worth 2 shillings by then, that the coins still in circulation were almost entirely melted down for the value of their gold. Only 8 gold pennies are known to survive. It was not until the reign of Edward III that the florin and noble established a common gold currency in England. The earliest halfpenny and farthing, 1/4 of a whatever a D is, found date to the religion of Henry III. The need for small change was also sometimes met by simply cutting a full penny into halves or quarters in 1527. Henry VIII abolished the Tower Pound of 5,400 grains, replacing it with the Troy Pound of 5,760 grains, and establishing a new penny weight of 1.56 grams. Although confusingly, the penny coin by then weighed about 8 grains, even, and had never weighed as much as this 24 grains. The last silver pence for general circulation were minted during the... Where am I? I've lost it now. Sorry about that. We're at 40 minutes now. 40 minute documentary about pennies. That's pretty cool. Okay. The last silver pence for a general circulation were minted during the reign of Charles II around 1660. Since then, they have only been coined for issuers, Maudy money, royal alms, given to the elderly on Maundy Thursday. United Kingdom. Throughout the 18th century, the British government did not mint pennies for general circulation, and the bullion value of existing silver pennies caused them to be withdrawn from circulation. Merchants and mining companies, such as Anglesey's, Parry's Mining Co., began to issue their own copper tokens to fill the need for small change. Finally, amid the Napoleonic Wars, the government authorised Matthew Boulton to mint copper pennies and two pences at Soho Mint in Birmingham, 1797. Typically, 1 pound of copper produced 24 pennies. In 1860, the copper penny was replaced with a bronze one. 95% copper, 4% tin, 1% zinc. Each pound of bronze was coined into 48 pennies. United States. The United States cent, popularly known as the penny since the early 19th century, began with the unpopular copper chain cent in 1793. The penny that was brought to Cape Colony in what is now South Africa was a large coin, 36 millimeters in diameter, 3.3 millimeters thick, and 1 oz, whatever that is, 28 grams. And the 2 pence was correspondingly larger at 41 millimeters in diameter, 5 millimeters thick, and 2 is that ounces? It's ounces. 57 grams. On them was Britannia with a trident in her hand. The English called this coin the cartwheel penny due to its large size and raised rim. But the Capetonians referred to it as the devil's penny, as they assumed that only the devil used a trident. Coins were very unpopular due to their large weight and size. On June 6th, 1825, Lord Charles Somerset, the governor issued a proclamation that only British sterling would be a legal tender in the Cape, South African colony. The new British coins, which were introduced in England in 1816, among them being the shilling, 6 pence of silver, the penny, half penny, and quarter penny in copper, were introduced to the Cape. Later, 2 shilling, 4 penny, and 3 penny coins were added to the coinage. The size and denomination of the 1816 British coins, with the exception of the 4 penny coins, were used in South Africa until 1960. Criticism. Handling and counting penny coins entail transaction costs that may be higher than a penny. It has been claimed that for micropayments, the mental arithmetic cost more than a penny. Changes in the price of metal commodity combined with the continual debasement of paper currencies causes the metal value of penny coins to exceed their face value. Australia and New Zealand adopted 5 cents and 10 cents respectively as their own lowest denomination, followed by Canada, which adopted 5 cents as its lowest denomination in 2012. Several nations have stopped minting the equivalent value coins, and efforts have been made to end the routine of using pennies in several countries, including the United States. In the UK since 1992, 1 and 2 penny coins have been made from copper-plated steel, making them magnetic instead of bronze. So that was an entire Wikipedia article about pennies, simply titled Penny. So that's probably going to be my best read I've ever had. And I think that is probably the most education I've ever taken in at one time. I think I've gotten a lot smarter since reading that. And you know what? It's 15 minutes until the 1 hour mark, the end of this part one of this documentary. I'll probably make part two on paper currencies, maybe, because paper currencies to me are a lot more controversial than metal coins, because paper currencies somehow are worth more than a metal coin, which has to be mined from underground, when a paper note only has to be a tree gets cut down, gets turned into paper, and then you just mass produce paper money. But billions of people die each minute to mining to mining the metals necessary to make enough pennies to make every single item on Earth cost whatever it costs, with a 99 pence at the end, so everyone gets a penny back. And also, I might make a part three eventually on digital currencies, because digital currencies are taking over paper currencies and metal currencies. So I'm thinking I might make an entire hour, or maybe 7 hours, on digital currencies, paper currencies, and metal currencies, similarities and differences. Some of them are obvious, but nobody knows what the obvious ones are yet because I haven't told you. But yeah, so far I think this has been the best documentary ever to be documented in history. I don't think anyone could possibly do better than this. And I'm pretty sure that this will be the main focus of every single school. There's going to be schools dedicated to this documentary and whatever documentaries come after it. So, make sure you listen to every single second of this, otherwise your life is meaningless and you don't have the what's it called now? You don't have the rights to live. So you have to listen to every single said second of this entire documentary, especially the Wikipedia article. That is the most important part. So don't skip to the middle, don't skip to the end. No timestamps ever given for this. People have to watch the whole thing, otherwise the FBI are called around their house. So, eventually there'll be another one of these, and maybe another two of these, covering multiple different topics about currency, because currency is great. And also, I'll link my PayPal to paypal.me/ebicboy, spelled EBICBOI, no spaces, no caps. Send me money, and I will do a drawing of immense skill level. I'll send you some samples of my best artwork so far. I'll do like Photoshop if you pay me like £200. I'll Photoshop anything with absolute professional skill. So, coming close to the end of this 50 minutes of this whole documentary, the end of it. So, I just wanted to say that pennies are probably the most interesting object on Earth. So, right now, you should grab yourself a penny, grab yourself 2 pennies, and put them in your eyes and not blind yourself. I'm talking to you, person who I don't remember the name of. So, anyway, make sure that you remind me what that person's name is, and don't blind yourself when you put pennies in your eyes. That's the whole thing I'm trying to teach you here. Imagine in South Africa, you were a South African person in that time when the pennies were absolutely massive. You put them in your eyes, you slip, and the entire penny just goes straight into your eye. And that's the end of that. You're blind. So, person who I don't remember the name of, you're lucky not to be South African during like 1827 or whenever it was, because you would not have been so lucky. So, this is basically the end of this entire documentary. And, yeah. There's like a few pennies left, a few silver pennies, or a few gold pennies left. If you have one, give it to me for free, and I'll sell it for money, and I won't give you any of it. So, yeah. send me money. PayPal.me/epicboy. Don't forget that. And, yeah. Goodbye.